Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install Eclipse IDE and also set it up for Java and run your first Java program. So let's get started. Just go to Google and type Java JDK download and you'll be getting the first link as Java downloads. Just click that. It is from oracle.com and here we will be having Java 20 and Java 17. And Java 20 is the latest version of Java, the latest JDK version. So you can just go here, scroll down, you'll be having it for different operating systems. We are going to download it for Windows. Just click on Windows and here you'll be having MSI installer. So just click on that. So it is about 158 MB in size. So just be patient till that. So once the download is completed, just click on open. You need to click on next and you can just change the location if you want to. The default is fine for me, so I'll just click on next. So the installation will begin. That's it. So once the installation is complete, you will be getting this successfully installed message. Just click on close. So now we need to add our Java path to the environment variables. All right, so just go to the folder where you have installed Java. So by default it's going to be C, program files, Java JDK 20, and you'll be having this bin thing. So you need to copy the till bin folder. Just Control C, just go to search and type environment. You'll be getting the edit the system environment variables option. Just click on open and in this you'll be having here environment variables. Click that and under system variables just click on path, edit. You need to click on new and you need to just paste this. Alright, you need to have till bin folder and just click on OK everywhere. Now just open your command prompt. Just zoom it. So we need to run the command java hyphen hyphen version and hit enter. So here you can see that I'm getting Java 20, which is the latest version of Java that we have installed right now. Just go to Google and type Eclipse download. You'll be getting the first link, eclipse.org. Just select that and here you'll be having this install your favorite desktop IDE. Just click on download and you'll be taken to this page and you can just click on download over here and your download will be getting started. So it is about 124 MB in size. Just be patient. Once the download is complete, you can just double click and you'll be getting the Eclipse installer like this. And here we need to select the type of Eclipse that we are going to install. So we are having Eclipse IDE for Java, C, C++, Embedded C++, PHP. We have so much options over here. And the main focus in this video is going to be like for Java developers. So I'll just click on this. And here you can see it has automatically detected our Java JDK, which we installed earlier. And this is the installation location. If you want to change it, you can just change it. And this is fine. Just click on install now. And it will ask you the agreement. Just click on accept now and the installation process will begin. So once the installation is complete, just click on launch. Make sure you check this both. So this is going to be the directory where our Java file is going to be present. If you want to change it, you can just click on browse and change. For me this is fine. I will just click on launch. So it will take some time for the Eclipse IDE to load since we are loading it for the first time. So we will be getting a welcome screen like this. Just close it and we need to create a new Java file and a project. So for doing that, you'll be having here create a Java project. You can either click this or else what you can do is you need to go to file and you need to just click on new. Here you will be having something called as Java project. Just select that and here it will ask you the name of your project. You can keep whatever you want. I'll just keep on demo. I want you to like uncheck this module thing. Yeah, we don't need this at the moment. We are just going to run a simple Java program. And this is the default location. If you want to change this, you can just change this. I will just go with the default location. So once you're done with this, just click on finish. And here you can see I've got a folder and inside that I'm having this source folder. So you need to just right click on the source. You need to go to new and here you will be having something called as class. So we'll be creating a Java file with a class inside it. Just click on this and here you can see we'll be getting the package name, the Java class name. So I'll just go with demo. That is going to be my class. And here we are having some options like public, package or something private. I will just want you to go with public. this should be none. And here you'll be having something called as which method stubs would you like to create. So you need to just check this public static void main, because every class requires a void main function. Just add these. I will just leave the rest as default and just click on finish. So here you can see I'll be getting an interface like this. And now for changing the font size, just go to Windows, and here you'll be having preferences, and in this you'll be having a search box. Just search for font. Here you'll be having the colors and fonts. Select that. Here also you'll be having a search box. Search for text space font, and here you'll be having the third one. Click that, and here you'll be having the size. So let me just go with 20 and just click on OK everywhere. Apply and close. Here you can see our font size has now increased. So final thing, let me just show you how you can run this. I will just close this. Yeah, so let me just have a print statement. So it's going to be system.out print. Alright, and for running this, at the top you'll be having this green color play button. Just click that and just select this and just click on OK. And here you can see we will be getting the output over here. Just a print statement, and that's it. So this is basically how you configure Java in Eclipse and run your first program. I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I run a lot of videos in programming, C, C++, Java, Spring Boot, MongoDB, MySQL queries and other CRUD operations, and AI related videos also. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.